Oakland. Ah, damn, here we go again. Hanging out the window, screaming out Oakland. Walking down seminary, finna like a visionary. Saw a fiend flipping out, the imagery was kinda scary. Everybody in my town wants to be legendary. I can look into your eyes and see if you're not ready, set, go. Gas when it hit the flow. While I'm looking at a car in a 25 zone. Doing 55 towards 55th. 50 cent in my pocket, get rich or die trying. Sad part is a lot of men die trying. Pour some liquor for the homie. Or maybe you could even change
your life. Hey, I'm Chris. I'm 24 years old. Weigh 190. I'm 6'2". We decided to make a documentary on my life around hoop and also my personal life on how I'm trying to become a better person. I attended St. Pasco Bayline before it closed down. My last year of elementary did St. Leo the Great. Graduated 2005. Graduated from this beautiful establishment, the Mary's House, St. Mary's, in 2009. Then I went on to Hampton University, graduated with my BS in Business Administration in 2013. And now I am looking to pursue a professional career in basketball. So this summer I plan to work out with a few different people. I'm looking to work out with Sam Moses of Jamtown, one Patrick Turner. He does some good work with a couple of the Warrior players and youth all over the Bay Area. Got Coach Steve. I worked with him at Head Royce basketball, and he does some good work as a trainer. And of course, Anthony Eagleton is going to be doing some work with me in terms of conditioning and weights. And can't forget my man, Deshaun Freeman. Deshaun Freeman is going to have some good workouts lined up for us. I'm hoping to get it in with these guys. And also, I have a goal to work with three pros this summer. Whether it be Kiwi, like I mentioned earlier, Jabari Brown, you know, Jared Cunningham, guys coming back from college, Isaiah Taylor, you got Delonte Robinson and Jamil Brown and people like that. So I'm just looking to work out with different people and challenge myself this summer, really push myself that so that I have the best opportunities when I'm playing.
Right now we are at the lovely Ira Jenkins, Brookfield, home of Damian Lillard, you know, so. We got games up here every Saturday, Adult League. It's pretty good competition. Pretty good competition. Just something to get me going while I'm waiting on these calls and workouts. It's pretty good, though. I like it.
What's up, Sam?
Just feeling good.
Weekend, I try to get two games in, so there's usually a league on Saturday, a league on Sunday. staying consistent. That's the biggest thing.
Getting into the zone. I like to do a dribbling series that I do with one ball. I always like to do that before the games. You know, shoot form shots, not necessarily game shots, just because we don't have so much time on the court. And I love to do this exercise, just jumps. I call them jumps, simple jumps. So as you can see, like when I'm just on the court waiting to play or waiting for the next game, I got a series of jumps, so I'll use a line and I'll do about 20 just regular jumps, 20 spread my feet out, do some jumps, and then single leg jumps. And I've been doing that, I want to say, for about the last 4 years, same jumps. And these jumps can be done with a jump rope too, so I could always use a jump rope, but those are mostly like my pregame rituals. While I listen to music, make sure I got a ball in my hand, I'm dribbling, just, you know, listen to some music, got the sets going, and then my jumps, as I call them. Just jumping single leg, double leg, just to get my body warm. My body has to stay warm to warm up, because it doesn't take me that long to get into the game and sweat and, you know, feel it.
Never, ever, why does everything never seem to be enough? With nothing good to say, that's when they start speaking up. I need a peace of mind, each line freezing up. Tell the devil I ain't moving till my lease is up. Told you I was leaving, didn't believe me much. They question where I'm going, will I keep in touch?
See me now, it's my time. Feels good on top. Yeah, I'm in my prime. You will remember me.
Keep out the gold nuts, ain't he? Don't blame me, no point in a finger. Kill it like Toby looking for Katie. Where the ghost at? Same place my focus at. Trying to get my focus back, like when I was dribbling in cul-de-sacs. I would not allow myself to sound close.
I think it's important to have a ritual, just because for me, before any game, whether it's a pickup game, my high school games, middle school, I always have jitters. And to this day, there hasn't been one game that I played in, whether it's pickup, a game that counts, a game that doesn't count, that I haven't had jitters. So a pregame ritual is definitely, definitely important for me. And then just thinking about post-game, what to do with the post-game after a big win or a big loss. You know, sometimes big losses are hard to come. Like when you have one, it's hard to come by. I hate losing, period. So after a loss, what I usually do is, you know, whoever was able to come with me to the game, I ask them first, like, what did they see? Any type of criticism, anything I did good, mostly I want to hear the bad, just because that's going to make me better in the long run. So usually my dad will tell me, if my dad comes to the games, he'll let me know, you know, what I could have done better. He's a pretty hard critic, so he'll let me know what I did wrong and barely tell me what I did right, you know, even if we won. But after a loss, he'll let me know. And then hopefully I'll have some game film where I could watch it, because I'll watch it right there. If it's on an iPad, I'll watch it in the car. Or if I can transfer it on my laptop, then I'll watch it right after. But definitely the game film after a loss. After wins, you know, it's not too much different. You know, if it's a good win, but I've seen I could do some things better, I'll definitely watch film. But, you know, I just usually have to work out. Honestly, work out. So I'll watch the film, I'll do all that, and I'll just work out after the fact. So, you know, I think those are some things that I definitely do post-game. Whether it's a loss or a win, it doesn't really matter, because I'm back in the gym right after. My workouts, like you said, ritual, my workouts are definitely like that too. You kind of want to do the same thing. It's almost repetitive, because I think about all the greats that are born, you know, do the same thing over and over that nobody else is willing to do, but that's how they perfect it. So whether it's basketball or lifting, like everything is pretty much a ritual. It's always, I feel like you always got to stretch something. Even if it's just for, like, I use that for like 17 seconds, you know what I mean? Like, but that's every day, every single day. A couple things that I try to do throughout the week are work on my core strength and work on conditioning. So if that's running a mile every day, running 2 miles every day and doing the core strength, then I'm probably doing that either 5-6 times out the week, at least trying to. So, you know, just trying to get some good balance. Always working on balance. Because when you're shooting, sometimes when you're shooting, you just gotta be on balance in the old type of weird ways. Yeah, so, got two sets of that. That's pretty much burnout. As many times as I can give it up. You know, some days are better than others. Give it, like, you know, like anywhere from 5 to 8. You know, like 135. Two sets of a lot of reps just to build up stamina. So knock that out. Always get my arms, get my core, get my legs, and everything just fall through. Off of the basketball court.
Not sure though. They're probably lying.
Steady rolling with big dreams, big dreams. 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 Steady rolling with, yeah.
Give keys, anybody can do it, just gotta stay consistent. So, matter of fact, got one more. That's what for. Then, what I usually do is just some ball handling, too.
Yeah, hey, live it in the game. I'm playing beyond the fame, taking off out the key. I'm never seeing the lane like the cane. So go ahead, adjust your levels, cause you know it's game time whenever the dust settles. Game face on, positioning for the tip off. Playoff atmosphere, I'm trying to get a chip off. Pick and roll, slip and go, got the coach tipped off. Fast break just like Rafe, I gotta skip off. This is my life, I'm more than a hooper, man. Flying through the sky, I'm magical, call me Superman. I'm in the A arena, balling next to Phillips. Home court advantage, I'm treating it like I'm Billups, yeah. Call me Twinkle Toes, better put a dancer on them. I traded teams and they still ain't got an answer for them. Cancel for them, I'm sicker than Mike in game 5. Hesitate for a second like Walker and then I drive. I thrive for it, your traps can't hold me tight. 61-36, I be Kobe-like. Know me like champs in the clover be the proof. If the big ticket don't get it, then Jesus or the truth. About to take over, 3 seconds left on the clock, game over. Dwayne is a shame, be doing it so easy. State to state, they call me great, so Beasley. From the west to the east, I'm an all-star. Roster be deep as a cello, heart of Carmelo. As a rapper, I'm a raptor, yeah, Chris Bosh in it. CP3 to number 6, bet I'm live in it. They ain't stopping it, y'all ain't even blocking it. And if he was, T-Mac would still probably rock it. What you expect? It all be the same, cause if it's in the game, then I guess it's in the game.
Say my favorite gyms, most definitely St. Mary's in Berkeley, the high school I went to. Great gym, great atmosphere, real compact. So the fact that it's small is just like everybody's in there. Real family feel, crazy games, crazy audience, you know. So I had to say St. Mary's is one. Went out to the Philippines, I played in General Santos, their main arena. I can't tell you the exact name of it, but I just know it seated about 5,000, 6,000, and they were all there screaming, cheering for me, cheering for the whole team. I have to say that those are like some of the main favorite gyms I played in. Altogether, the workout though, I love working out at my gym, 24 High Street, of course. Because I've been going there for so long, I want to say this would be like 8 years that I've been going since I was 16, since I first walked in. 24 on High Street and Jamtown. Jamtown, if I could give them a shout out, because Jamtown's let me work out there so many times, working out with Big Sam and just getting some good run, getting some good adult league games. It's a pretty good run at Jamtown too. So High Street and Jamtown, 24 Hour Fitness. Those, I have to say, the main gyms. So being from Oakland, as everyone knows, we have a lineage of great guards, great basketball players, but mostly great guards. When you think about Gary Payton, Jason Kidd, Brian Shaw, of course, those are the first names that come up. But when I was playing, I had Deshaun Freemans and Quinn Thomas's, Mondo's, had a bunch of guards that played great, and even my peers today. Kiwi Gardner and Jabari Brown, who are my cousins. You got Jared Cunningham, also Damian Lillard, of course, man. Gotta rock your shoes, man, for Oakland. But
What we all have in common is that we have a crazy amount of love for the game. And that's both on the defensive and offensive end. If you see those guards that I named, they're aggressive on the offensive end, but they take it personal when somebody scores on them. So I think that's where I get most of my mentality is with the defense first mentality, because I don't want anybody to score on me. So the best thing to do is make sure I lock my man up and I have more points than he does at the end of the night. So I think that's one thing that all Oakland guards have in common, is that we don't want to be beat by one individual. We want to come out with a W, but we also want to do way better than our opponent on the defensive and offensive end. So coaches that I would like to play for or that I have played for, that's a tough one. There's a bunch of coaches out there right now. I did some work with the basketball team at Head Royce High School, and the head coach, Tony Melendez, was one person that I had to believe I would have loved to play for at some point, any time in my career. He's a great coach. He had fun with it, very loose, but he was also hard on you. He let you know when you weren't doing something right, and you know, if I had him in high school or college, that would have been just problems, because it would have been a great thing to have him as a coach. In terms of the NBA, I gotta love the Warriors basketball system. Everything that they're doing with Steve Kerr is implemented, and Luke Walton, Ron Adams, those type of coaches have really made a difference for the Warriors, and it's because of their style of play, which doesn't get enough credit also. Another coach that I could think of off the top of my head, Lynn Moore. He coached me when I was younger, and he helped introduce me to the game. Alan Moore Sr. helped me introduce me to the game of basketball, which I love so much, because his son was playing. And when he was coaching me, he taught me some life lessons while I was playing. And it was definitely something that I take to this day. And this last one, you know, is just kind of a little bit off topic, but if I could get a coach, I would love for my grandmother who left us 2 years ago. I wish she would have coached me at any point in my life about anything, just weight room, teaching discipline, and more outside of hoop, because basketball is one thing, but if you could get coached in the life lessons and outside of basketball, that's another thing. And I think if my grandma were to be a coach, she's probably laughing at me like right now, but if she were to coach, she would have instilled a bunch of hard work and dedication into me that would have had me ready for the next level, and that will have me ready for the next level. So, love you, Grandma.
I was just okay at it at first and just wanted to keep getting better with it. So, you know, I think that's a big thing. Find a real love for the game when you keep going, when you know you're not maybe good at something. You want to keep trying to be the best you can. I just had a drive for it. That's why I still continue to play today.
I made this film. Try to make sure that, you know, we have people that are trying to accomplish a goal, whether it's playing basketball or just helping out in the community or just bettering yourself, period. Just wanted to show people that with hard work and dedication, you can get anywhere you want.
Because my last year I did the track. I did the track and field, which is how I got to Hampton. I did a little bit of it at Hampton. Got Justin over here too though. I don't know why he had me running, but we had a relay. I was the anchor, I want to say. Right over there. Nas, Hope Lovers, man. I love you. Love you to death, boy, but you did not have to burn me like you did, bro. I got burnt. Straight dash. I got second, but he served. He killed me. Well, I just stepped the ball.